Hey y'all, did you ever wonder why we talk about noise in terms of colors, like white noise and pink noise? Did you know there's also blue noise and purple noise, and even velvet noise? Real quick, I want to go over these different colors of noise, what they sound like, and how we can use them creatively. First, let's talk about white noise, because if we understand why we call it white noise, then all of the other colors start to make a whole bunch of sense. When we're talking about noise, we want to talk about the spectrum. And again, the spectrum of a sound is all of the different frequency components that make it up. Now, the other place that we talk about spectrums is when we talk about spectrums of light, the good old Roy G. Biv rainbow. And so we call white noise, because it's actually an analogy about light. White light consists of the other different colors of light mixed together. That's why we can break them out into a rainbow with a prism. And so, in this metaphor, white noise then contains frequencies all across the spectrum at even amplitudes. White noise sounds like this. But another common type of noise you've heard of, pink noise, sounds like this. Okay, with pink noise, we're also using this same analogy of light. So if we think about white light, how do we need to change the spectrum to make it more pink? Maybe we'd reduce the amount of light on this right-hand side while leaving a bit more of the reds in ratio. And you can hear in the pink noise, compared to the white noise, that it does have fewer of those high frequencies. As a matter of fact, the amplitude of frequencies decreases 3 decibels per octave. So those of y'all into synthesis knows that's like half a pole of a filter. Pink noise is useful because of our perception. Without getting too much into the math of it, the frequency spectrum of pink noise is linear in a logarithmic scale. And we perceive pitch in this same logarithmic scale. Think about an A440. In order to go down an octave, we need to halve that to 220. Back to the 440. In order to go up an octave, we need to double that to 880. Now, the lowest A was 220. 220 to 440 is only 220 hertz, but the 440 to the 880 is 440, it's further away. So it's the same idea with pink noise. Rather than having all frequencies of equal power, you take that range of 220 to 440, which is only a band of 220 hertz, and you give that the same power as the band from 440 to 880. So every octave contains the same amount of energy. So you can see how this might be musically or perceptually pleasing. Well, there are a whole bunch of YouTube videos that show you how to mix to pink noise. All right, knowing what pink noise is, it's easy to think about what red noise is. Confusingly though, red noise is also called Brownian noise or brown noise. And the brown in there has nothing to do with the spectrum. It's named after the botanist Robert Brown. Getting back to it though, red noise sounds like this. Compared to pink noise. Compared to white noise. And you can hear this is like pink noise, except you have even less power as you increase the frequency. In pink noise, amplitude decreases 3 decibels per octave. In red noise, 6 decibels per octave. Now the reason that this red noise shares a name with a botanist, Robert Brown, is because noise isn't just useful for us to listen to. Noise can be useful as control data and modeling different kinds of natural processes. That's a bit more than we want to go into in this video, so instead, let's now flip the spectrum. Back to white noise. How about some blue noise? Blue noise is the opposite of pink noise, so the amplitude increases 3 decibels per octave as we increase frequency. This blue noise, and the next step further, violet noise, which increases 6 decibels per octave, can be useful for introducing some high-frequency randomness into a signal. A few other colors of noise worth quickly mentioning. One is gray noise, which is white noise that has a psychoacoustic loudness curve applied to it. So this gray noise has a perceived equal loudness across its spectrum. Here's white. Here's pink. And here's gray. There's also green noise, which exists in the middle of the spectrum. The definition of green noise seems a bit flexible, and most recently, if you do a search for green noise, what you'll find most often is noise marketed for relaxation. Again, probably an unofficial definition, but it seems to be green noise is centered around 500 hertz, rolling off frequencies above that at 3 decibels per octave, and rolling off frequencies below that at 3 decibels per octave. I mentioned at the beginning of this video velvet noise. I don't think velvet is actually a color, but velvet noise is created by random pulses, both positive or negative. It can be useful in creating reverbs, but once again, that goes a little bit beyond what we can talk about in this video. As a Kyma user, I should mention hot pink noise, which is a necessarily digital kind of noise, again, beyond what I want to get to in this short video. And last but not least, there's black noise.